Can a nation really practice agriculture without soil? How does a city-state with barely any farmland feed millions of people? Singapore has an answer to these questions. This small island, just 720 square kilometers in size and covered in skyscrapers and concrete, is redefining what farming means. But how does Singapore achieve the impossible? Vertical farming towers, soil-free hydroponic systems, aquaponic farms that combine fish and vegetables, and AI-driven technologies. Singapore's story is not just about food security. It's a glimpse into the future of agriculture. So let's explore, step by step, how farming is possible in a world without land. Singapore is one of the most densely populated city-states on Earth. Over 5.7 million people live within just 720 square kilometers. Only 1% of its land is suitable for agriculture, which is nowhere near enough to meet the demands of traditional farming. The country imports 90% of its food, eggs from Malaysia, vegetables from Thailand, fruits from China, and rice from Vietnam. In short, Singapore's plates are filled by the soil of other nations. But climate change, pandemics, or geopolitical tensions can quickly turn this reliance into a serious risk. Aware of this danger, Singapore's leaders began asking, even without land, can we still produce our own food? In 2019, they set an ambitious goal, 30 by 30. This strategy aims to locally produce 30% of Singapore's nutritional needs by 2030. Basic staples like vegetables, fish, and eggs are expected to come from within its borders. But for a country without farmland, even 30% is a bold and challenging target. That's where Singapore's agricultural innovation and technology come in. At the heart of this agricultural revolution is vertical farming. While traditional agriculture requires vast open fields, vertical farming grows crops in stacked layers, maximizing yield from minimal space, a perfect fit for land-scarce Singapore. Sky Greens, a Singapore-based company, developed one of the world's first commercial vertical farming systems. Here, plants grow in rotating trays stacked 9 meters high. The trays turn slowly to ensure equal sunlight exposure. Rainwater is used for irrigation, consuming 95% less water and yielding 10 times more per square meter than traditional farming. Leafy greens like lettuce, spinach, and bok choy thrive in these towers and make it to supermarket shelves quickly. These vertical farms also rely on renewable energy and LED lighting optimized for photosynthesis, reducing energy waste. Rooftop gardens are another key part of Singapore's urban farming strategy. With so little space for traditional fields, crops now grow on top of skyscrapers. Tomatoes, peppers, beans, and herbs are cultivated on rooftops like that of the Capita Spring building, which hosts a 1,400 square meter farm. These gardens supply fresh produce to local restaurants while reducing the urban heat island effect and saving energy. To encourage more rooftop farming, the government offers tax incentives and subsidies. Community gardens are also booming. Over 2,000 have been established as of 2023, with a goal of reaching 3,000 by 2030. These spaces don't just grow food, they reconnect people with the practice of farming. Hydroponics is another cutting-edge tool in Singapore's farming toolkit. In this system, crops grow in nutrient-rich water instead of soil. Water is recycled, saving up to 90%, and growth rates are higher. Companies like Growbricks are bringing hydroponic systems to offices, restaurants, and homes. Their green wall design can grow dozens of plants in tight spaces. Hydroponics also reduces the need for chemical fertilizers, making it an eco-friendly option. Old warehouses, parking lots, and unused buildings are being transformed into hydroponic farms, bringing agriculture into the city center. Aquaponics is another standout innovation. This system merges aquaculture with hydroponics. Fish waste becomes natural fertilizer for plants, while plants clean the water for the fish. Some farms in Singapore use this method to raise tilapia and grow vegetables at the same time. It's a zero-waste closed-loop system and a game-changer for sustainability, producing both protein and vegetables in one setup. Singapore is turning agriculture into a high-tech industry. Artificial intelligence and automation are transforming how farms operate. Sensors monitor water, light, and nutrient levels in real time. Robots handle planting and harvesting, reducing labor costs and minimizing human error. In 2024, the National University of Singapore developed a biotech platform that accelerates plant growth and boosts yields by up to 20%. Despite all these innovations, Singapore currently meets only about 10% of its food needs domestically. To hit the 30% target by 2030, it must triple its current output. So, what's next? Singapore's 30 by 30 goal is driven not only by technological innovation, but also by a comprehensive strategy that includes government funding, education programs, public-private partnerships, and international collaborations. The Singapore Food Agency, SFA, fuels this vision with significant investments in the agritech sector. In 2022, SFA allocated an additional 165 million Singapore dollars to the Singapore Food Story program. This funding supports sustainable urban food production, alternative proteins, and food safety research, aiming to boost local production and strengthen Singapore's agritech ecosystem. Singapore offers various financial programs to support agritech startups. The Agri-Food Cluster Transformation Fund provides grants for farms to upgrade their technological infrastructure, acquire new equipment, and adopt sustainable practices. For example, Sustner Agriculture used these funds to expand its high-tech vertical farming systems, producing lettuce and kale at 30% lower costs than imported alternatives. SFA also fosters international collaborations. A partnership with the Netherlands sparked innovative projects like GrowGrace, which operates in a 720 square meter warehouse using Dutch dry hydroponic technology to produce 33 tons of fresh produce annually. Additionally, SFA encourages local companies to produce overseas and export back to Singapore. Sustainable Agriculture was among the first to implement this strategy by opening a vertical farming facility in Hong Kong. This approach helps Singapore overcome its limited land and labor challenges. The 30 by 30 goal goes beyond food production, encompassing education and community engagement. Singapore inspires younger generations through hydroponic farming programs in schools. Institutions like Republic Polytechnic introduce students to urban farming techniques, making agriculture accessible and appealing in cities. These programs show that farming isn't confined to rural areas. It can thrive in urban environments, sparking greater interest in agriculture. Community gardens are a key pillar of Singapore's urban farming strategy. As of 2023, over 2,000 community gardens flourish across the country, with a target to reach 3,000 by 2030. These gardens encourage citizens to engage in farming, fostering community bonds, and contributing to local food production. For instance, Citizen Farm promotes community-driven agriculture, empowering individuals to grow their own food. SFA supports local farms with marketing assistance and collaborates with supermarket chains like FairPrice to create dedicated shelves for local produce. This boosts consumption of local products and reduces reliance on imports. Moreover, the government isn't just focusing on large investors. It's also bringing small entrepreneurs and individuals into the fold. Campaigns promoting balcony farming, hydroponic starter kits, and mini greenhouses designed for shared use by apartment residents aim to make everyday people part of food production. This transforms urban farming from a professional endeavor into a part of daily life. The core idea behind all these efforts is clear. Farming isn't just for the countryside. Food security is a shared responsibility, not only for farmers, but also for cities, engineers, teachers, and consumers. With this approach, Singapore is perhaps redefining one of the modern world's greatest dilemmas, urbanization versus food production. The 30 by 30 goal remains ambitious. Whether Singapore will achieve it is something we'll watch closely. But one thing is certain. Singapore demonstrates that even in seemingly impossible scenarios, technology, thoughtful planning, and collective will can create sustainable solutions. There may be no soil, but where there's vision, seeds can sprout anywhere. See you in the next video.